Hi, families. I'm here today to talk to you about daily schedules and daily routines. So, our brains thrive on predictable patterns. Our daily and weekly patterns have been flipped upside down without any warning. So, to help you create the new normal, that begins with creating a new daily routine. Families with older children, you can sit down with them and have them help you co-create a schedule that works for both of you. Families with younger children, you'll want to create the schedule yourself and then present it to your children as if they were part of it and get them excited about it. So if you're new to creating a daily routine at home because you've been working and your child's been in either daycare or preschool, that's totally okay. We'll make it. It can be very simple. The simple bare bones, and that is enough. It's even better than over scheduling or over planning or creating something that's so complicated that you can't remember it, your child can't remember it. That's not effective. So simple is better in this case. So you can plan it, draw it, label it, and then post it. If it's not posted, then it will be forgotten. So post it somewhere obvious. I recommend in the kitchen by the fridge because everyone gets in the fridge every day. Little children get in the fridge every day even if they're not supposed to. So they'll definitely see the schedule there. Refer to it often so that your child knows what to expect. The goal of creating a routine or some kind of rhythm to your day and knowing what to expect next is to help your cultivate a sense of safety in your child when they could be feeling confused and not knowing what's going on and feel kind of scared because things aren't the same anymore. They all feel sad. They miss their teachers or friends. So we really want to help you create a sense of safety and security with your children. And that's what my goal is to help you with today. So let's see an example. An example of a successful, simple schedule would be number one, wake up. Number two, get dressed. Number three, eat breakfast. And you can chunk it like that. You can make a schedule when you draw it. You can do, the first three things. Wake up, get dressed, and eat breakfast. Then you have another line. Okay, now it's project time, outside time, and then lunch. So things are split up into like an hour and a half or 2 hour chunks. You don't need to go any smaller than that because it will be hard to remember exactly at 10:15. I know that I won't remember something like that. So I make larger chunks of time, less things to remember, which means it will be used more often. Okay, after lunchtime, you could do, that would be free play time. Then after that, for an hour or 2 hours, it will be family time. And part of that could be playing the game together, watching a movie together, and then preparing a meal together, because after that could come dinner. After dinner, because the kids in our program are very young, it's probably after dinner you go straight into bath time, brush your teeth, get in your PJs, read, and do your bedtime routine. So anything more than that would be probably overwhelming, but something with just these bare bones of structure can help your child feel a lot safer and feel like they are in control and they know what to expect next. I hope this was helpful. As always, if you have any questions, please reach out to your classroom teacher on class tag or through email. And you may always reach out to your family support coordinator as well. So, thanks for listening. Bye.